Hello there, awesome YouTube folk people of the internet 2.0 and stuff like that and everything that makes this world what it is. So today I want to talk about something which I really love, which is color grading. For a little bit of background, if it's your first time on my channel, I'm a filmmaker and I've been a filmmaker for the past about 7 years. And before that, I was a photographer for like another seven. And for me, color, like just what story color tells, to me, it's always been something I'm the most passionate about. So today I just wanted to talk about how to color grade some GoPro footage. Lately, I've been filming everything on the GoPro 12 black. It kind of like surprised me how such a small camera can make such great images. And on top of that, today I'm going to show you a plugin, which is Dehancer. They reached out to me and said, hey, do you want to test our plugin? And as a disclaimer, they don't pay me. They gave me the plugin for free. Also, they don't have a say about what I'm going to say in this video. So, I'm just gonna start my screen recording. So this is some footage that I have, some random footage I shot in a lot of different environments, which is fun because it's gonna show a lot of different scenes, a lot of different light. That's kind of my note tree here. As you can see, it's quite complex and I tend to go very granular in my edit, but the thing is, afterward, I can use that on many other shots. What I want to see is how can I take that style DNA and kind of like do something similar, maybe a little bit more stylized. I'm gonna give you a little rundown of what everything does. So here it's a color space transform, which basically takes the input color space of the GoPro, which is Rec 709, and put it in DaVinci Wide Gamut and DaVinci Intermediate. What this does, it makes it easier to apply this node tree to different cameras, because I come from using Reds, I come from using Blackmagic, and they have a different color space. And what this does, takes like all those different color space and transform them in the DaVinci color space. And after that, what you want to do is have another CST, which is gonna turn your DaVinci Wide Gamut back into Rec 709 and output Rec 709A, because I'm on Mac and this is what I need. And then from there you have the HDR, which is basically just I'm lifting a little, my shadows a little bit and lowering my highs, expose. I don't use the exposure every time because sometimes you don't really need it, but when I would use it, I just go in the HDR and just, you know, you can make it darker and brighter, but that shot was decent enough. Contrast is self-explanatory. You just add a little bit pop to everything. And then this is only a node, so I can go in my node tree here, which is saturation. That was before DaVinci 19 came out with the color slice. I used to have a way more complex way to handle saturation. Now I just use that. And then I have my highlights, because I want my highlights to have a little bit of, you know, that yellowish tones, and you just have a little bit of bloom. And if we make it way too exaggerated, you can see that I have a lot of yellow here tinting my highlights. Then halation is very subtle. Halation just like gives this little bit of a red tint around the highlights. And then I have my glow here and my grain here, and then a vignette, and then another color space transform. And then I do a final adjustment to just, you know, not have my black too washed out. Just, you know, final touch. This is how I usually color grade. I use that on all of my professional shoots. and it works well because I have a lot of flexibility and I can basically just tweak things as I like. And now I just want to see if the Dehancer can get me there in way less nodes, bring me a little bit of extra oomph, because sometimes the tool you use are kind of influencing you, which is a good thing. Okay, I spent a couple of minutes just deconstructing the node tree I have here and to see how I could use the Dehancer. What I came to was that here. What have we got here? Basically, we have a CSD, which is gonna, you know, do the same thing, transform the color space, a little bit of HDR exposure. I'm playing with the HDR exposure. I just call it HDR because I work in the HDR color wheel. Contrast. I kind of like to give it a little bit of pop, so a little bit of contrast here. As I said, I used a color slice instead of my very convoluted way of doing saturation, a little bit of color warper here to help with managing the blues, because the blues were really popping. And then the Dehancer, a little bit of a vignette because we all love a vignette. Another color space transform, a little bit of adjustment because usually really appreciate just a little bit more of a depth in my shadows. And I find that this does the job. Just, you know, you can see the shadows being a little bit darker. I don't like shadows are too milky. Let's go into Dehancer and play with it. Dehancer Pro 7.2.1, whatever that means. And I've put my input in DaVinci Wide Gamut Intermediate, because this is what I personally use. I really like that you have those type of color space, because if you're dependent on a camera, some camera are not even in database. Is GoPro in there? As you can see, GoPro is not even there. So if you're not using DaVinci Wide Gamut, you're a little bit fucked. Here I use Kodak Image Pro because quick like that, it's the one I personally like a lot. I don't know how accurate these are, but to me it'll look good. Film developer, you basically add some contrast, gamma correction, color boost if you want more or less color. Film compression, so this basically will compress your highlight and your low light, just a little bit like film. Color density is a different way of working with saturation. So let's go to expand. This is your black point. This is your white point. How much of it you want to affect your image, I guess. Just play around and you're gonna figure out. Print, it feels a little bit too much for me. It makes everything a little bit too crunchy, but if you like that, it's there. This is where it's getting interesting. Film grain, I personally love a good film grain. I personally feel like digital is a little bit too sterile. It's really good, honestly. You have these options and you can then play with it in the custom mode. And this is what I really like, because you can go there and you can play with the resolution of the film as well, which is cool, because what's happening is that film is not as sharp as digital. And I kind of like that. It just gives it a little bit of more of an organic feel. So far, really, I'm enjoying the amount of customizability. Talks as much to me and also talks to somebody who does not do that for a living. A lot of people just want to slap something on there and call it a day. And then one thing I like, halation. Halation is of a red bloom around the highlight. You can see here around the headrest, there's a lot of halation. As you can see, a lot of halation. Play with it and be careful, because it can be very violent, I feel like. And putting everything in excess, to me, like, too much is just too much. Same goes with bloom. I just want to show you how it looks like on 8mm. It's very apparent. And boom, now you have the highlight spreading all over the place. And yet again, you can just work with presets. and then go at in custom mode and, you know, play as you want. To me, this is great because I'm somebody who likes to be granular about my look and film damage. That's a hard one for me, like fake film damage never really does it for me, and so I'm just gonna not use it. And that's what's fun about it, is it's there. If you don't like it, don't use it. Film breath is gonna change saturation and highlight. It's this kind of breathing, it's just brief. And you have that here. Gate weave, we're gonna be able to see it on a locked up shot. You can see the image trembling a little bit. If I remove it, the image is perfectly stable. I like it. It's another tool to be creative, which is cool. Overscan. I mean, it's an effect. So I see what they're doing with that, but not something that I would use all the time. And then you have vignette. I'm very picky about my vignette, so not gonna use that one. And then monitor, which is cool, because now you can see what's overexposed, what's underexposed, where everything is sitting at. And then output is total impact. Oh, so you can dial it down. That's cool. I like that. That's pretty much the answer. Now I'm really curious, how would it look like on a bigger camera, like on a Red or something like that? Oh yeah. It gives a little thing, a little something, something that I really like. Now that I've played with this plugin a little bit, what are my thoughts? Hey Chuck, my boy. My crusty old man. So do I like it? Yes, I do. I think the elation is gorgeous. The grain is gorgeous. The bloom is gorgeous. It can make a tiny dinky GoPro feel a little bit more alive, feel a little bit more organic, which is to me a big win. Would I use it on professional project? Yeah. So this concludes my video. Have a nice day. Go on your bike, have fun if you're somewhere it's not snowing like shites. Ciao, my sassy beckies.